guys and false flags and orchestrated events. So you gotta analyze everything that comes about, man. You know, because a lot of shit that we see on the news is orchestrated, it's fake, it's phony, right? And that's why it don't make no damn sense, right? But this is 2 Corinthians 2:11. It says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant to his devices, to his plans. And his plan is to slander our people, beginning with us, the Hebrew Israelites, man, and to destroy us, right? And we know that, right? And just like our Lord, what did they do? They brought up false witnesses against our Lord. They're going to bring up false witnesses against us, man, in the media, because the servant is not greater than his master. So they're going to try and paint us in a very, as if we are evil. You know, is this where murderers and all this kind of stuff, when we ain't doing nothing, we're harmless as doves. All right, all we do is teach the word, you know, and bring forth the truth of the scriptures and condemn them in their evil. All right, but this man is full of deceit, right? That's his power, man, falsehood. One of my favorite scriptures, man, Psalm 144, his right hand is the right hand of falsehood, right? Psalms 144 and 8, whose mouth speaketh vanity, and their right hand is the right hand of falsehood, man. And when, listen, man, when we get in the kingdom and we really find out all the lies this man was telling, we're going to be like, wow, like so much of world events and different things were just all manufactured and orchestrated. This man's the devil. He ain't called the devil for no reason. The word devil, slanderer, liar, deceiver. That's who this man is, man. And the scripture says he went forth to deceive the whole world, man. That's how this man operate, man. He international with it. Now I saw this, right? Hebrew Israelite teens and father found dead in home, right? Now, when's the last time someone was found dead in their home and they mentioned, what is the need to mention someone's religious affiliation? When's the last time you seen it say two Muslims, a Muslim teens? What the hell does someone's religious affiliation have to do with the fact that they were found dead in their home? Especially when, as you're going to find out, they don't even know the cause of death. Like, what the hell's going on here? Does this make any sense? So let's watch this, man, and see how many times they repeat the word extreme. You see, because they want to paint us, the Hebrew Israelites, as extremists. So see how many times that buzzword extreme is used in this hit piece. Because that's what this is. And I wouldn't be surprised if these girls ain't who they say they are, right? If the mother and father they got up here on the TV is all actors, I just wouldn't be surprised if these are all crisis actors and this is a completely fake event, because none of it don't make sense. Let's watch.
Alvarado says her former husband was following an extreme version of the Black Hebrew Israelite.
Black Hebrew Israelites.
And every time they say extreme, an extreme version, they actually don't even detail what it is that makes it extreme. What is the definition? What were they actually doing that was extreme? Yeah, are the Mormons extreme? Because the Mormons have their own thing going on. Are the Jehovah Witnesses, do they describe Jehovah Witnesses as extreme?